Happy Thursday, all. Thanks for joining me tonight. Here we are going to work on block 99 of the Splendid Sampler Quilt Along. It is new block Thursday, only one more new block day. This Splendid Sampler Quilt Along only goes through block 100, and that will happen Sunday. So this is the second to last new block Thursday, block 99. So thanks again for coming in. Thanks, replay viewers, for joining me. Hey, Mary Jane, thanks for coming in. And thanks, YouTube viewers, for watching. This will go up on YouTube at Penguin and Fish Movies when we're done here, and it will stay on Penguin ampersand Fish on Facebook as well. All right, guys, I'm going to flip you around, and we'll get going. Hey guys, happy Thursday! Thank you guys for coming in tonight. Block 99. We've almost made it. We've almost made it to 100. Kind of nuts. This block I think is actually pretty clever. It's it looks really complicated, but it's only two shapes really, and it's gonna go pretty quickly, I think. I'm excited for it. So another pieced block tonight, block 99 of the Splendid Sampler Quilt Along. You can find out more info at thesplendidsampler.com. You can still get all these blocks for free for maybe another week and a half. So it's time to download them now. Otherwise, it will be a book coming probably. It's on pre-order right now, but it'll probably be out maybe around summer or fall, I'm not sure, but go check it out on at thesplendidsampler.com, and it's on pre-order at Amazon, The Splendid Sampler. If you're new here, my name is Alyssa Thomas from Penguin and Fish, where we make lovely and quirky hand embroidery patterns and kits. I'm the author of Sew and Stitch Embroidery and a fabric designer, and I'm here every weeknight at 9:30 p.m. Central. And Diane, you got your fabric today. That is awesome. We just got our new fabric collection in. It's the little safari suite animals, and I've been starting to ship those out. I'm hoping to put a newsletter out about it soon. I've only talked about it here with you guys on Facebook. If you're interested, check out the Facebook video I did where I showed all the fabric. It's called, I think it's Fabric Sales in the title of that Facebook. And you can just message me if you'd like some. Otherwise, I will have a newsletter going out about it soon. And if you're there, you can read about it there as well. So, all right, I'm going to flip you around and we'll get started. Thanks again for coming in tonight, guys. Okay, here we are. Oops, there we go. A little jiggly to start out. So block 99, four corner spinwheel. So what's nice about this block, so it looks super complicated, right? But it's actually just a couple flying geese. So we have a flying geese unit there. And a flying geese unit is where we have a rectangle and then we put the two corners on each rectangle, right? So we actually, here are four flying geese units. And then we have like half of a flying geese unit. We have a rectangle, which is only one square on, and that's all these other corners. So it's just, that's it. It looks really complicated, but that's all there is to it. The complicated part comes from the different ways the colors are on here. And I printed this out in color because I wanted to choose colors that were similar to it today. So I'm going to do, again, we are on block 99, and one of my biggest issues at this point is having enough fabric to do this. So that's one of the reasons why I chose some of these fabrics. So this is going to be my pinwheel, the dark kind of blue purple right here. I'm going to do this kind of pinky red that I really love this one. I'm going to do that as the inside part. I don't think I have enough light colored fabric for the background to be one color, so I'm going to combine it. These two colors will be my background, like pale yellow, and then these outside little corners I'm going to do in this wacky orange that we've used here and there. So that is my plan. So first things first, let's cut. I may have to, I think I'll press these all first. I don't think I'm going to spray starch them tonight. I think we'll just We'll try and do this all without the spray starch. All of these fabrics are pretty close to the same thickness. Like, they feel, they all feel kind of the same, so I don't think I need to really starch it. We are dealing with triangles, so it might not hurt to starch it, but you know what? I'm kind of feeling like let's just get cutting and start sewing and see what happens. The pieces are a little bit bigger, I think, on this block, so we might be okay. So just starting by prepping my fabric a little bit. They've all been scrunched up in my bin. This one looks pretty good, actually. I'm excited to use up more of this fabric. Look, see, these are my light-colored fabrics. I have hardly anything left. This much of this cute little floral. The Heather Ross print, and barely any of that too. Light fabric. I think this one's by Barry J, if I remember right. And here we go, the fun sketchy orange. Wow, we're even almost out of this. I feel like I haven't used this one as much in the Splendid Sampler, but I mean, we start out with a fat quarter or a fat eighth, and it's almost gone, so I guess we've used a bunch of that too. Oop, and we got a little stray here, out of here. Okay, so let's check this out. So I think I'm going to cut the rectangles first. So we need 4 2-inch by 3.5-inch rectangles in C, which is our pinwheel color. So that's this one. And then we also need it in our A fabric, 2 inches by 3.5 inches into the A fabric here. So that's one of our light colored fabrics. So let's see how that goes. I think we'll start with this one and work our way with it. So I think I might actually cut. Normally I would stack my fabric and cut it at the same time, but since this is just so wonky, I think we are going to just do both separately. So, all right, 3.5 by 2 inches. I need 4 of them, so I need at least an 8-inch area here. Oops. I think we have it. Maybe we have it better this way. That's just 10 inches. Well, at this point, it's about exactly the same. At this point, it doesn't even really matter much because we are almost done, and I'm going to just use the rest of the fabric for the back of my fabric. I don't know exactly how much fabric I started out with. So on the Splendid Sampler homepage, oh, your fabric arrived today too. That's awesome, Valerie. I'm so happy to hear that. But if you go to the Splendid Sampler page, they'll give recommendations for how much fabric. I think they said something like 30 to 35 fat quarters. So I did, you know, I had a half a yard of some, even more of others, and then some I only had fat eighths. So I just kind of grabbed as much as I thought kind of equaled that 30 or so fat quarters. And I think that's actually kind of a lot, but, you know, I'm also ending up with, you know, barely any left of some. So if you do 30 fat quarters, I'm thinking you'll have plenty to play with. Oh, I cut the bunny in half. Oh, no. I should have maybe left him. Oh, well. All right, so let's just cross-cut some of these. Here I can use on my... Could do this on my little guy here. Valerie, I'm so happy you like the fabric. I am about to get started on my next collection. And by next collection, I mean the collection after the one I already did after this one. So I'm actually going to start 2 collections beyond the one that... just came in the mail, which is kind of crazy, I think. So it's actually It actually, I do a collection about every 6 months, and it takes a year for them to come out. So the one that I'm mailing out to you guys now, I've actually designed a whole collection since then, and I'm going to be starting another one real soon here, too. So if you're curious about some of the process, it's that long in between. All the way to Canada in less than a week. Oh, that's nice. Sometimes, you know, you guys had that whole strike thing going on for a while, didn't you, for a little bit there? So that kind of held up mail for a little while, but good. Sounds like it's back cracking. All right, so here's our first four. And again, I would normally cut these together with the other fabric that's this size, but that other fabric is such an odd shape. So, all right, our first four, throw that to the side. Let's try and get, all right, how are we going to do this? So I need 3.5 by 2. So I wonder if this is 8 inches. So not quite. What about here? No, so I'm going to have to maybe 2 inches here. So I could get 2 inches by 3 inches here if I start. Oh man, I'm going to just have to cut and see where we end up, I think. So let's start with a straight edge. Straight edge here. Actually, you know what? I might start with a straight edge here. So I am going to cut this shorter, but I think I might have enough over here. I don't know. If I don't have enough with this, I'm going to just pepper in that yellow, and we'll kind of see how that plays out. It'll kind of be a mix, which I think will be fun. All right, there's the first cut. Okay, so now this is where I gotta figure it out. I'm gonna be able to get, if I do 2 inches, or the 3.5 inches this way, I'll be able to get a few, but then I'll have to, that's not enough. I am gonna have to do more. I would love to do another kitty collection. We'll just see. I don't think that'll be the next collection, but I'll have to pitch that again, because that's always fun. Kitties are always good. So I did already do a kitty collection. I'll have to check to see how that one did, and then maybe they'll let me do another one if it went well. So we'll just see. But that would be a fun one to do. I could do it a little differently than last time too. So just make it different. Here, Kitty Kitty was the last one. That was fun. It had a lot of kind of pale, cutesy colors, and I really liked it. Puppies would be fun. So that's one I have not done before. And that would be really neat, I think, because you could do a whole pile of different puppies. Kitties are kind of easy in that sense, because you either you can do either like short haired kitties or like long haired kitties, or you know, like Persian looking kitties. It's not, you don't have like tons of different animals or tons of different breeds. I mean, you do, but they all look similar enough that you can kind of decide what it is on your own. Whereas dogs, there's like so many different kinds. But that would be fun in a fabric collection, because I could do a whole pile of different puppies. All right, one. You know, I feel like I'm not super paying close attention to what I'm cutting, so hopefully my dimensions are okay. Ooh, yeah, I don't think we're gonna, there's a big cut out of that one. I don't think we're gonna get our four out of this. Maybe I can squeak one more out of the fabric I've left over, but I'm not sure I have enough. We have 3. All right. Is this 2 inches? That's the question. I'm not sure it is. Oh, man, it is right on the line, and I also have a nick out of it. I wonder if that'd be okay. So it is a rectangle that we are going to cut that half square triangle out of. So this actually might be okay. If I, this is the straight edge that we cut. So let's just get a good edge over here. Hey, Leah, thanks for joining us. All right, let's just see if we can get 3.5 inches. All right, and then we're gonna need to trim that 2 inches out yet. Also need a picture of the puppy. Oh, teddy bear. Oh yes, send me a picture. I will totally do a little doodle of him. If I do a puppy collection, I'll throw him in there. That'd be fun. That'd be really fun, actually. That'd be a super fun idea, actually. If I do a puppy collection sometime, I'll have to pitch that. But if I do one of those, just like, you guys can all send me your puppy photos and I'll do little portraits and have them in the, like, hidden in the collection. All right, so that was not a great piece. So I'm a little shy here. Make good use of the fabric. Well, I don't know. I'm hoping to put a lot of all my scraps in there somewhere. Oh, basting hexies. Oh, nice. Wow, that's a good traveling project. Okay, so, you know, it's not quite 2 inches. I got a weird edge here. And I got a little nick out of it, but this is gonna have, in theory, a half square triangle, or like a triangle there. So I'm gonna trim this off anyway. So I have to keep my eye on this one and make sure, actually, you know what? Now that I'm looking at it, I don't know if I can do that because they're all going this way. So I might not be able to cut that off. Nope, they're all, my piece is going the other direction, but you know what? I think I might risk it still. So this is like a little shy of a quarter inch, so I might still be able to sew it in. I think we're gonna risk it. I'm gonna have a little nick in my seam allowance, but you know, we're gonna deal. I don't think the whole thing will fall apart. I think we'll be okay. So I'm gonna just keep going. All right, so those are all of our 2-inch by 3.5-inch pieces. Now we just have a pile of 2-inch squares, and that's all there is for cutting. There's nothing else here. So, all right, we need the E fabric. That is our background. We might have to cut a lot of these separately, too, because I have such odd shapes at this point. Bees, which is my other light colored fabric. Not much of that either. D. Oh, that's our little pinwheel fabric. And I think that's, oh wait, no, we got another one. Oh, I said that one already. Weird, I must have gone in opposite order. So let's just double check. B we need, that's this one. D and E. All right, these three, and we need 4 2-inch squares of all of those. So, okay, let's give that a try. All right, so that means we need another kind of 8 inches if we're going to just cut them all at once. So let's see what we got going on here. This looks pretty good. Yeah, we'll have it out of here, but all these other ones I'm not too sure about. Ooh, this one might get an 8-inch this way. Yeah, 8-inch. Is that 2 inches? Yeah, all right, so this will be good with this one. I'm gonna actually put this one on the bottom because this one we have a bunch of selvage we have to cut off. It'll be easier to see. So we'll go right like that. And then this crazy guy, I don't know what we'll do with this, but we'll add it to the mix here so we can get a few cut out of it, and then I'll have to cross cut and do a few more out of here. Yeah, we've had the super duper cold here too. I think we woke up today and it was 1 degree out, but tomorrow it's supposed to be like 45, so we're going from 1 degree Fahrenheit to 45 degrees Fahrenheit overnight. That's crazy. Oh, 66 there, oh, that sounds amazing. That's like the perfect temperature. Oh my gosh, you're 10 inches over the, oh man, 10 inches of snow over the weekend. We haven't had that in a while. We've just had that super dry cold. It's been that dry cold this year here for us. All right, 2 inches. Man, a 2-inch square is looking small again. To me, it's just kind of funny. Funny to me. How little these guys end up. All right. So we can, we'll cross cut that, but while I got this good straight edge, I am going to trim one more strip of yellow here. All right, I want to keep these guys together. One more strip, because we're not going to get enough 2-inch squares out of that other one. You know, and I'm kind of tempted actually to cut one of those 2.5 by 3-inch squares out of here too, just because, or 2-inch by 3.5-inch squares or rectangles, to replace one of my, that light one that was weird. I might just, let's just trim this and do that too and see if we like it or not. Then we're not risking that big nick I have out of that. I have this fabric, so might as well use it. It might look fun with it all kind of weird and patchwork together. I kind of like that idea anyway. Ooh, this fabric's hard to see on my cutting board. It's because it's about the same color. Alright, how about like that? Oh, rather than news before work in the morning. Oh, Joe, that is so funny. That's awesome. I totally appreciate that. I'm trying to get them, they take like overnight to upload, and then in the morning and sometimes the afternoon, like sometimes I'm not ready to do it till the afternoon, I have to write the description and publish it and stuff still, but I'm trying to do that in the morning. I had a couple of like, this is that 3.5 one that I'm doing. I'm like, why am I cutting just one piece? But I'll stack these ones and do the two inches out of it. But I've had a couple of mornings that I'm just barely getting up and getting ready for the day, and I'm sick of it. I like my getting up early and having coffee and reading my book a little bit, but I've been rushed these past few mornings. I don't know. I need a weekend of recovery, I think. So, all right, here's my replacement one, just in case that one white piece here, you know, I don't like that one with the nick in, so I might just replace it and do these as my four. We'll just see. All right, and then we still need to cross cut these to the 4 inches. I think I'm going to throw it on my tourney mat again, just because it's fun to use. Oh my gosh, you raised mini American Shepherds. Oh, gosh. Oh, just send me just whatever. Just send me like a screen grab or just a simple camera photo. It doesn't have to be any, you know, high resolution or whatever. But yeah, I'd love to see them. And yeah, I would totally, that'd be fun. You know what? I should do a puppy collection. I'm kind of actually surprised that I haven't done that yet. So I will put one in the works to pitch it. So how this usually goes is, the fabric company will either be like, hey, why don't you try doing a collection about this? And they'll suggest something, or I want to make sure I got that bottom piece, yep. Or I will do the same thing with them, like, hey, I was thinking about doing this for the next collection, and they'll let me know if they like it or not, but I think, I don't know how you can go wrong with a pile of puppies. So I think I got to put that on the agenda. So yeah, if you guys want to send me puppy pictures, just send it to info, I-N-F-O, at penguinandfish, or, you know, you can message me on Facebook or any of that. Message me on Facebook at Penguin and Fish on that page. I think I need four of these. Then that's awesome. I love photos to help me out to draw them. Do you have one with cats? I have a fabric collection. This is that weird rotary cutter that keeps loosening. I do have a fabric collection of cats. However, so I don't need these guys anymore. It's older, but it's actually not that old. It's maybe 2 years old, but in fabric land, fabric nowadays, which is kind of annoying, but it's a lot like the fashion industry where you do a collection and then 6 months later, it's all gone. Like you can't find it anywhere. And which is a bummer because people have just finished their quilts and stuff by then. And you know, they want backing and stuff for their quilt, but it's hard to get that fabric anymore. So, there is fabric out there. It's called Here Kitty Kitty. So if you do a Google search for like Here Kitty Kitty and either like Clothworks is the company that prints it or Penguin and Fish or Alyssa Thomas, some combination of that will get you some of the Here Kitty Kitty fabric that exists yet. I don't have any myself anymore. I'm sold out of it, but that's what it's called, Here Kitty Kitty. All right, so we got our four of each of these pieces, so I'm just gonna get those all together, and we're ready to sew. But what I'm gonna do first is make sure that we kind of lay out this design, because I think this is a design that I'll get confused pretty quickly, so I kind of want to see it in front of me while I sew. All right, here are the last two of those. I'm feeling like we're missing something, but I don't think so. Nope, five different pieces, so here we go, and I am going to replace that one, I think. So our four of the lights are going to be goofy like this, but I think that's kind of fun. So, all right, let's lay it out here, and then I will, I'm going to just use this as a guide, and then we'll start sewing. Okay, let's start on the inside. We got our four rectangles. So those kind of go like, wait a sec, yep, like that, and that, whoop, and there, kind of like these guys. Okay, and actually, then we have the light pink guys. They will be going, I'm going to just kind of give these a little fold. So we're going to be sewing right on the diagonal. So once we put it with one of these, we'll be going right on the diagonal like this. So I'm going to already kind of put a fold. Instead of drawing a diagonal, I'm just putting a little fold going the diagonal. I'm not trying to stretch it. I'm just pressing it down like this. And then I can see that diagonal. So I'm using this as a guide still, so the diagonal goes that direction. I don't want to go this direction by accident. I want to go this direction. So I'm going to just lay that there so I know where it goes. And I'm going to do the same with these other four. You know, something I didn't think about, I should maybe make sure that I'm rotating, getting these, this is kind of a directional fabric. It's got this zigzag. It'd be fun if that rotated around too. So I'm going to try and fold them all in the same direction so that when I lay them down, they'll all be kind of rotated. So let's try that this way. And this one's horizontal. Is your ShapeFlex water soluble? ShapeFlex. I'm not
sure what shape flex is.
All right, now this one has to go. All right, I screwed up already. So this goes this direction. This one goes this direction. There we go. Down that way, this way, that way, one more. I know, this dark fabric is super fun. Oh, like a summer night sky. Oh, I like thinking about it like that, too. Okay, that's good. That's how I'm going to think about it. All right, and this one goes this way, although I've totally messed up the direction of these fabrics, so let's see. How did I do that? I think this one I wanted the other way. But now I'm going to confuse myself, I think. Alright, so this one's vertical, horizontal, vertical, horizontal. Cool. Then it'll look like it'll spin a little. Alright, so those are those pieces. And then, you know, we have the other half of those half square triangles. I'm going to just lay those next to it for now. I'm not going to do the folding on them quite yet. We'll just, we'll sew these first. What's the stuff you used when embroidering? Oh, the sticky fabric selfie. So, is that what you're talking about? Sticky fabric selfie. It's by Selfie. That is water soluble. And it sticks on like a sticker and then it's water soluble. I kind of love it. All right. And then these are the outside ones. And again, we are going to get triangles on there. So let's do the same thing. Let's get our little fold in there. It looks like, according to the instructions, that we do these outside pieces first. So, all right, they are going that way. Again, I'm just looking at the diagram. Oh yes, so Bonnie, I always print it out. What I love about the sticky fabric selfie is that I can have a design on the computer, right? Or on my phone or something, and a device, and I can put a piece of the sticky fabric selfie into my printer, and, oh, you used it on Block 31, awesome. You can put it in the printer and print out the design, and then just stick it on like a sticker. So that means you avoid all tracing, which is awesome because tracing blows. It's just, you know, you have to spend so much time tracing the design onto the fabric or, you know, onto carbon paper or something. Whereas with the sticky fabric solvy, all you got to do is print right to it. And you can also trace onto it too, which comes in handy. But I love it, the sticky fabric solvy. There was a weird, sometimes it was that gooey kind, but in general it still has worked really well. Okay, I'm going to start with these corner pieces on the sewing machine, and you know what? It looks like, oh yeah, I have, it looked like I didn't have thread in the machine, but I think we're good. You know what? I'm going to chain piece this whole thing. So I'm going to start by chain piecing these outside ones, and then since I've done like the fold on these inside, I'm going to do the one side of the insides, and then we have to do the other side yet, but we can't do the other piece until we've pressed it, but I can at least do these outside pieces and the first sewing of that. So let's just do this all at once. You know, there's, like I said, this is a complicated looking block, but it's actually really quick and easy, I think. Alright, so I'm going to go right on the line here. Let me get my little stiletto to have on hand. And I always like sewing from the middle to the point, because if you're sewing from the point to the middle, a lot of times the sewing machine wants to push that point into the machine. So I feel like if you go from the inside to the point, it's kind of a little happier. I'm actually going to go a hair to the side that we're going to cut off here. So a hair to the seam allowance side, which in this case is, you know, towards the corner here.
whenever I get the Shape Flex, is there a product called that? Because I got it at a cool job. Oh, Shape Flex. Oh, that's so funny. It wasn't what I was expecting. Oh, so I have no idea what the Shape Flex is. If you want some sticky Fabrisilvy, I have that on my website. So you can search at Penguin and Fish if you want to try that out. But yeah, Shape or Flex, Flex, Shape Flex. I am not sure what that is. And I think I just lost a square. Oh, yep, I did. here we go. This goes here. My sweater snagged a square. That's always fun. Have you done that where you, you know, like when I laid my whole thing out here and then all of a sudden there's a square missing, but it's just stuck to me. Shape Flex for making purses. That could be. It sounds like a name of what an interface would be. It sounds like it'd be like a interface to use with like knits or something, because knits need to like flex and move still. But I'm totally just guessing. I have no idea what it is. That aisle is so scary. That interfacing and stabilizer and all that aisle, like it's, you have to really know what your objective is going in there. Otherwise it's just really confusing. Did I mention something with flex? I'm trying to think what that might have been. Maybe one of the iron-on stabilizers, Heat and Bond, we used, and Wonder Under, and the Steam-A-Seam. That's the one that we haven't used yet, but I'm trying to think of with a flex, and I'm not sure we mentioned anything with flex. All right, so there's that. Now I'm going to do these inside ones, and these are the ones that I, you know, kind of was messing up, so let's try and get it right from the beginning. Okay, we'll start here. These ones are in the opposite direction. That'll help me. Hi, Lorraine. I'm like, why does this feel funny? And it's because I'm sewing with my shoes on again, which is just silly because I don't feel like I have an aversion to sewing with my shoes on. But whenever I do, I feel like I can't feel the pedal as well. And then I'm confused, but it's because I still have my shoes on. Usually when I'm sewing, I'm all chilled out. Oh, wait, you know what? I totally did that wrong. See, okay, so I just did what I didn't want to do. I started at the corner instead of the center, and the machine kind of ate my piece a little bit. See, it ate the corners, so I think I'm going to just leave that. But that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to start in the middle there. So ate my fabric. Let's try it again. All right, I'm gonna get another leader in there. This one is in the opposite direction. That's why I was a little confused there. Yeah, you know what, these are my running shoes, so I can't even pop them off very easily, so I think I'm stuck with them tonight, which is kind of annoying. Feels weird. Like, why am I can't feel it speed up and slow down very well. You know what I mean? There's just a feel missing. Like there's an accuracy that I can't feel. Look at that big ol' soul of a running shoe.
All right, here's the last one. All right, so we will press these, all 8 of these guys that we just sewed, and then we will come back and do the second one on this one, that the yellow piece. Alright, so I'm going to do that thing that we usually do where I'm not going to... So ultimately we're going to trim this off, right? So this is good, and then we'll fold this over. I'm going to actually fold and press it over first, because then I can use this edge as a guide to get it nice and square, to get in the position. But isn't that cute? I'm totally digging these two fabrics together. Alright, let's press these. Actually, we have to trim them all first. They're all stuck together still. Okay. Trim these all out. And this is that one that I... One of these are the ones that I got all weird. Oh, maybe it ended up over here. Okay. And then these ones. These were the first... the corner blocks. So we'll actually be done with those, because those ones don't get a second side on them. Oh, you found one of the stilettos at Dazo, so you'll use that. Oh, cool, until you get the turkey laser. I know, isn't that nice? I love this. It's just a turkey laser with some beads, and it works magic. Like, it's just the right length. It's got that really sharp point, and the beads, you know, are a nice handle. I love it. All right. Up here. Where'd this guy come from? Oh, he must be a scrap. It's a little bit bigger. Okay. Let's press. Oh, that's right. I have two different fabrics here. All right. So I'm going to just set the seam and then fold it over, again, using that edge as a guide. And then we will ultimately be trimming that away. There we go, just like that. I think you can find a turkey laser at a grocery store or something. I'm sure it's easy to find around Thanksgiving. I don't know if you're in the U.S. here, but I'm sure they'd be easy to find at that point. I'm sure you could get one on Amazon. But yeah, they're just called turkey lasers. They're those things to, like, when you cook a turkey, that keep, like, the wings in place or something when you're cooking it. Kind of like toothpicking it together, I think. I don't know. That's what they're used for, aren't they? I think so. All right, that's two. We got 8 of these. And then we have the other side of the one. So we might get all these little flying geese sewn tonight, I think. Then it's just assembly of the whole thing. So I'm pretty sure that we'll get this done tomorrow, which is great. So that means, so I'm planning on doing my Saturday mini marathon again. And that means we'll be done with this one before that. So we'll have to pick some fun blocks to work on Saturday. All right, so these are kind of in the opposite direction. Get some of my unfinished blocks done. I'm not sure I actually have a block that we can finish in one sitting. So on Saturday, we'll get a little farther on something. I don't know if we'll actually get done on anything though. But this guy will be for sure done tomorrow. I'm thinking there's not much left to it. Which again is so cool because it looks like a really kind of intricate, fun pieced block. So the turkey lasers are kind of bendy. Like mine's actually a little bent, but that's only because I've used it a lot and use it to push down fabric and stuff. But you know, they're so inexpensive and kind of fun that, you know, it's okay still. I mean, it's not like a scissors. Like, if I push down on this for a long time, it's not going to bend because it's, like, I don't know, steel or something. But, you know, it's not so bendy that it's going to be a problem, the turkey lacers. Cute and fun, that's what they are. And functional. Fun and functional. Alright, those guys are done. Let's trim them. So you can either, so by trimming, what we're going to do is trim the seam allowance so that now that we've pressed it, we don't want all this bulk anymore. If we accidentally sew it in, then, oh well, we have all that bulk, but it doesn't, we don't need it, so we're actually going to trim it out. There's a couple ways you can do this. You can get your ruler and go right by the seam. Go a quarter inch from the seam, like this. Just lay it right on the diagonal and cut your quarter inch. And that's scrap. There you go. So you can go like that to get your perfect quarter inch. I just grab my scissors and do it. It doesn't have to be perfect. So I'm just flipping this up open and then just trimming about a quarter inch away. And to me, that's perfectly fine. So that works for me. But if you are a rotary cutter person who likes their nice, perfect seam allowances, feel free to open them up and use your ruler and trim them. I'm perfectly fine with just doing it with the scissors. All right, these are our insides, and then here are our little outside pieces. So we'll re-put our little design together now, and then sew the other sides of the middle piece. If you add beads, make sure the opening is big enough. Oh, that's smart. I never thought about that. If you use those rubber earring backs as a stop, oh, fit up into the bead. Ooh, that is smart. Anyway, that's smart. I like that idea. Huh. I'll have to try making some too, I think. They do come in handy. Just an earring backing getting up in there. Oh, I love that. Clever, clever. One more of these. And then, like, I think you still want to use, like, a hot glue gun or some sort of glue to hold, or that, you know, super-duper super glue to kind of hold it in place and still, like, put some glue. Maybe at each bead, maybe even, I don't know. All right, scraps out of here. All right, let's lay this out again. See if I did it right. So we should be able to see our pinwheel now. And it looks like, there we go. Yep, so I did the vertical, horizontal. Great, so that turned out, I was a little nervous about that. So these are gonna go on the other side of this pinwheel. And, oh, that'd be fun. A project for when the Splendid Sampler is over to do that little stiletto. Try and make one of those. That'd be fun. All right, here are our corner pieces. We have that one that's the same color up there, which is funny. All right, there, like that. So all we're doing now is these other squares sewn on these rectangles here. So we're going to do the same thing we did at the beginning. I think we have 10 minutes or so left. I think we can totally get these sewn, and then we'll just sew the whole thing together tomorrow. So again, let's actually get these guys out of the way. They're in my way right now. We need the piece to go this direction. So again, I'm just folding it, and I'm doing this instead of drawing a line on them. Oh, you made them for a quilting group at church. Oh, that's smart. Man, that would be a great project for a quilt group like that, or a quilt guild to do. All right, so I'm going to just lay them out all in the same direction. They have that line on. Oops. Ooh, across the room. You know, I could do this just as easily instead of folding by throwing the throwing a ruler on here and just drawing a line down the diagonal. And actually, you just start sewing and just aim for the diagonal. That's how I used to do it before the Splendid Sampler. But I don't know. We're getting more accurate with the Splendid Sampler here. So I'm doing this fold thing so I can actually see the line instead of just aiming without a line on the diagonal. Alright, that is the third one, and then one more, and then we will chain piece all these as well. So that should go real quick. Then that whole ironing thing again, and trimming, and we will lay it out, and I think that will be that. We will finish sewing it tomorrow. I think we'll actually have a bunch of time left tomorrow as well, so maybe we'll work on another block tomorrow. Tomorrow too. We'll see. See how it goes. Okay, here we go. All right, again, I'm going to sew from the center out. And again, with the shoes, I can't feel the pedal at all. One. Yep, Valerie, I think I am going to do, oh, thanks for coming, Aaliyah. I am going to do the marathon on Saturday, so we will be done with this block, which is awesome, unless the feed isn't working tomorrow or something. And I don't know what block we'll work on. We got all sorts of blocks to do, like paper piecing and embroidery and, you know, English paper piecing. Even a normal piece one, I think we have hiding in there. And applique, we got the whole gamut to do in unfinished block land. So I'll just have to, I'll page through it and see. You know what would be, you know what one maybe we should work on? Is the juggling balls one. The one with the three circles and that squirrely little bias strip. Maybe we should get that one done. That one's kind of hanging out there as a one that, you know, wants to be finished. They all want to be finished, but that one, maybe I'm feeling that one. I don't know. We'll see. All right. So that's that. Let's trim these. And again, we will press them first and then trim the little half square triangles out. So here we go. We'll go like that. Very cute. I like it. You know, I didn't even think of it, but I have all that yellow in this purple, and that kind of matches the yellow that we have in here. Wasn't thinking about that when I picked this fabric. I was just trying to think, oh man, what light fabrics do I have left? So I suppose once you pick your fabrics, they all start to kind of work together because you've chosen them for the other parts of the quilt already, so no matter what, it'll fit with some part of the quilt. Open at the doctor's. Oh, happy to have you here, Jennifer. Oh, wow, that one was hot. Okay, two more here. And one more. So next up, I'm going to trim these again, and then I'll just lay these out. We'll see what we have and call it an evening, probably. I mean, we actually do have like 5 minutes or so. I don't think we can sew this whole thing together in that time, though. So I think we'll just trim this and then call it. But I want to lay it out again to see what we got. Hey, got to stay to block 100. I know. Okay, so Sunday, you know, I'm not doing weekends anymore, so I won't actually start the last block 100. I won't actually start that on Sunday. I will start it on Monday. But crazy. Block 100. We're getting there. All right. So here we are. You know what? I'm going to lay it out so it's all cute on my white piece of board right away. I always kind of like laying it out in here. I think it's just so cute. So, you can hang out with us too. So, okay, let's get our centers going. Our little pinwheels. I gotta look at the picture again. There, this way. Yeah, there we go. Now I got it figured out. I always get confused when I lay stuff out. Oh, Jennifer, me too. I'm so happy I stayed on this too and proud because this is just not, it's a big project for me, the Splendid Sampler. I don't usually stick with projects this big or stick with things more than a month, you know, like the exercise and all that. So I'm just really happy that I was able to stick with this. So this is like a double pinwheel, actually. We have that red pinwheel on the inside and then this darker pinwheel on the outside. That's kind of cool. So there, like that. So next up, we'll be sewing all these together as squares, like that. And then we'll just have a four patch, which is just four squares sewn together. We'll have that and that's it. So, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more seams to sew, and then we're finished with this one. But I'm liking this. These are crazy colors. I would have never picked these colors to go together at the beginning of the Splendid Sampler, and they do look kind of crazy here, but, you know, with the rest of my blocks, they'll fit right in, which is kind of funny. So, all right, there we go. Thanks so much, guys. I'm going to flip you around, and we'll call it an evening. Hello, hello. So that was quick. This, again, this was definitely one of those blocks where it looks so fancy, looks so neat, like the design is really fun, but man, there wasn't really anything to it, just a couple flying geese and a couple half flying geese, and then we're done. I know, oh, your colors are all crazy, oh, my colors are all crazy too, Jennifer, for sure, but I kind of love it. I'm so excited that we'll get Block 100 soon. I am ready to sew this quilt together. I want to do it so bad, and lay it all out and just decide where all the blocks go. I'm pretty excited about that, but man, I got ways yet. These 10 blocks that I don't have done yet are going to be ones that we'll be here for a while getting them done yet. But eventually we will get this all sewn together in a real quilt. So, all right, guys, this will go up on YouTube tonight at Penguin and Fish Movies. You can watch it there. Also, you could watch it at Facebook. It'll go up right away. You know, the nice thing about the YouTubes, just so you know, is that for the YouTubes, I'm actually recording what I see here. So you'll be able to see the chat come up if you're watching it on YouTube. So if you're watching a replay of this on Facebook, it might just be weird, like who am I talking to, when, and whatever. On the YouTube, you'll actually be able to see somebody, see the somebody say something, and then I'll be able to answer it right away. It'll be more in conjunction with each other, so that'd be a benefit of the YouTube watching. Otherwise, it's here on Facebook at Penguin and Fish Movies as well. So again, thank you guys. I will see you tomorrow. We'll finish this block up easy peasy, block 99. All right, guys, have a great evening. Good night.